Good afternoon and welcome to Markets Today. I'm your host, Mbithe Mwema. Now you can see the colors I'm wearing, and that certainly tells you today is Friday, February 14th of 2020. Happy Valentine's Day from us here at Markets Today to you, and we hope you're making the most in terms of spreading the love. And remember, it has to be equal. If you are female, spread the love with your male counterparts and vice versa. That said, what is happening in our world? We're very excited about what we have lined up for you later on in the show. I will give you a snippet as we go along. But firstly, we'll give you a highlight in as far as what was happening yesterday on the Nairobi Securities Exchange. We'll also give you a highlight in as far as corporate news is concerned. And you know, when it's Friday, the auction for the Central Bank of Kenya results came out overnight. We'll also be giving you an overview of what's happening there. But before I delve into this statistics and data and corporate information in as far as what's happening in the markets today, we want to engage with you and ask you, what would you want to ask us? Our hashtag today is Ask Mbithe. We're talking about the Nairobi Securities Exchange. We're on like our stocks 101 and trying to understand, hey, can I open an account? How should I go about opening it an account? Last week, we did have our friends from Genghis Capital walking us through an app that they have, which is the Jikuze app. Download it and you actually register online to be able to participate on the NSC. Now that we've crossed that hurdle, today we want to understand, okay, I have an account. I don't need to put in a minimum balance, but I do need to pick a stock or a couple of stocks rather to decide what am I going to invest in. Question is, how do I pick a winning number? And what should my key considerations be? In other words, if you're going to invest in the stock exchange, if you're going to be an intelligent investor, are you going to follow in the books of one of the investment world legends, that is Mr. Benjamin, who wrote a book, The Intelligent Investor? Or are you just going to go and do it in a haphazard way? There is a framework to winning in this market, and that's what we want to take you through later on in the show. The hashtag is Ask Mbithe. Anything that you want to know in as far as stock selection is concerned, and we will be addressing those questions later on. Twitter handle, that is Metropole TV, or Mbithe Mwema on Twitter. The Nairobi Securities Exchange, what happened yesterday? Volume was slightly lower compared to the previous day. The turnover was down 11% on a day-to-day basis, closing at 1 billion shillings in as far as turnover is concerned. 1 billion is a huge number, and we have seen a bit of this trading this week, largely driven by Safaricom. Safaricom traded 13.3 million shares at a price level of between 30 shillings per share to about 30.5 shillings per share. The dominance of this trade is largely the foreign investors who are both on the buying side as well as on the selling side. Today, it also continues to dominate trades there, and we have been seeing a bit of news trends coming out in this particular company. Two key things that we've heard. Safaricom is about to roll out its 5G network. We do not know who the providers are. It's highly suspected that it could possibly be Huawei, but that has not been confirmed by the company. The fact that they're moving into 5G means for them that there's actually demand for their product, and they're actually operating at near excess capacity based on the current offering in the market. 5G is exciting. 5G is very fast. 5G means you're going to be using more data, higher download speeds, higher connectivity to the internet. You can stream, you can upload videos. It's the next generation in as far as the usage of data is concerned. That is something that we will be keeping an update on, and anything comes through, you know, you'll only hear it first here on Markets Today. The second thing that we've also had in as far as Safaricom is concerned is a possible delay to a merger of one of their competitors in the market. Not really competitors, but other players in the market. And this is the Airtel and the Telkom merger. This could be delayed by up to 4 months as the two companies go and seek redress, because they have been told that they have to comply with stringent objectives if they were going to merge. They say that some of these objectives are way overboard in as far as their merger is concerned, and they are seeking redress, and they will be looking for about 4 months before they can get direction as to whether to go ahead with the merger as is or whether they will have to comply with some of this Competition Authority of Kenya regulations and requirements. That said, let's take a look at what was happening in the bonds market, rather the treasury bills market. Every Thursday, the Central Bank of Kenya is in the market looking for about 24 billion to fill its weekly requirement of corporate funding, not corporate funding, of funding from the public in as far as treasury bills are concerned. The issuances that we saw this week, there was the 91-day bill, 182-day bill, and the 364-day T-bill. The rates were more or less unchanged. The only thing that we did notice in this particular auction was a lot of interest in the one-year T-bill, that's the 364-day bill, and it saw about 39 billion worth of bids. The total bids that were accepted for all the three issuances, 21 billion. That is what the government took from the public this particular week against a weekly target of 24 billion. Corporate news, what is happening? We have one of the mid-tier brokerage houses that have actually come out yesterday and said they will be merging their operations. This is AIB and Apex. They will be merging their operations to create a robust brokerage company, and they will be looking to merge their individual market shares and hopefully to be able to compete with the tier one stockbrokers in Kenya. Now, this information came out yesterday, but we still need to see a regulatory approval from the Capital Markets Authority. But by the time we actually see this information in the market, it's more or less a done deal. How do you look at the stock brokerage business in Kenya? Unfortunate for us, it's actually dominated by three foreign-owned stock brokers. They tend to dominate anything between 50 to even 70% of trades in any given year. Will Apex and AIB be able to get into this space and be able to get a piece of this bigger pie? Only time will tell. But if you are an investor and you have opened an account with either of the two, then you need to be getting reaching out to them, to their customer service desks, and finding out what will happen to your assets and how will you engage with them formally from here on. And finally, the news of the day that is coming also through the pipelines. We have seen the Capital Markets Authority give the green light to Amana Capital in as far as holding back on a possible liquidity crunch for this particular asset manager. Now, Amana Capital has been having issuances with regards to liquidity. It did make some prior period investments and it lost some money, and that has meant that it's unable to make redemptions when the clients come through. In other words, if you go and want to collect your money from Amana Capital, you will not be able to, and you have been asked to wait for 30 days before you can access your funds. Amana Capital has been in the market, I think, for about a decade now. They have about 2 billion in terms of assets under management. They did make some investments in some of the fallen companies, the likes of Nakumatt Holdings, as we understand, and they did lose some money in terms of the corporate bonds that they had placed in this particular company. That said, the CMA, which is the Capital Markets Authority, has given them a point of regress and allowed them 30 days to figure out their liquidity issue and how to be able to manage what the returns that they need to give to their investors. We are looking to see what steps the stakeholders will take, the underlying shareholders of this particular fund, what steps they will be able to take to be able to give people back their money when they need it due. Now, this is becoming a pertinent problem when you're looking at the fund manager industry. Money markets, that's a key vehicle that we tend to use to be able to access some of these products. But now we begin to see a bit of shakiness in at least the the tier three fund managers, then it begins to beg the question, is there a systemic risk in the fund management industry? Is there something that could possibly topple over? In other words, will you be able to walk into any of your fund managers and be able to get your money out? Have you had any problems? Are you facing any similar issues such as the investors invested in Amana? We would like to know. Reach out to us. And as always, as we say, it's very easy to get into any investment. But always remember, this is Africa. Getting out is never as easy. There is a song that actually alludes to this particular fact, and this is Welcome to Hotel California, where you can never leave. So don't get yourself stuck into one of these vehicles and not be able to get your money out. That said, we finally come to the exciting part of this show. That's the part of Ask Mbithe. If somebody was to ask Mbithe what she wants for Valentine's, I keep saying, I want me some Safaricom shares. If somebody's out there listening, please bring me a whole bag of Safaricom shares. But that said, why do I think that Safaricom is a good stock? Why not another stock on the stock exchange? Why are the investors only looking at Safaricom and the banks? Is there no other opportunity on this securities exchange? That's the question that we want to answer after this short break. Ask us on hashtag AskBithe. What do you want to know? How do you select a stock and how do you make some money out of this stock? We take a short break and we will be with you shortly.